next continuation now. In this, just I want to explain some sums, two or three sums I will explain. From exercise 1 or 2, they will ask compulsory find the HCF of the given any two positive integers by Euclid division lemma or Euclid algorithm. So that is one important model question. Okay, that I will explain now. Example, find the HCF, find the HCF of 60 and 100. Find the HCF of 60 and 100. Okay, here A comma B, we can take these two values A as A and B. Euclid division lemma, according to Euclid division lemma, first in this solution we have to write given that what is given in the question, 60 and 100 is given in the question. Okay, according to Euclid division lemma, Euclid algorithm, by Euclid algorithm, what is our statement? In the form of A is equal to BQ plus R, where 0 is less than or equal to R is less than B. Okay, this is the condition. Then you have to divide, 100 by 60. Then you have to write the form. So 100 is equals to, we can write, first you need to divide with 60. Okay. 61 is 60. What is the remainder? 40 is the remainder. So this is the remainder. This is the quotient. Okay. Now here A means 100 is equal to B. B means what we can take divisor. 60. Okay. 60 into quotient into 1 plus remainder is 40. So you can write it is in the form of A is equal to BQ plus R. Everyone understood, ma? Here, next, with this remainder and this is the divisor. Both we can take again, we can do the division. Okay, 60 is equals to, divisor we can take as dividend, 60 is equals to, then you have to divide 60 by 40. Okay, now you have to take 60 and you have to divide with 40. Now 40, 1's are 40, remainder is 20. Okay, this is the quotient, this is the remainder. Okay, understood? Now, what is the divisor here? 40. 40 into 1 plus remainder is the 20. Next, again you have to take, consider divisor and remainder. Again, that 40 you can take as dividend. Divisor you can consider here dividend. Then you have to divide 40 with 20. 22's are 40. Okay, remainder is 0. Here quotient is 2. Now 20 into 2 plus remainder is 0. This is the last divisor in this process. Last divisor. Okay. Now, here in this process, this is the restatement of continued division method, means long division method. Okay, when here you should continue this process until and unless you will get the remainder is 0. Whenever you will get the remainder 0 in this process, that wherever last divisor is there, that is only the HCF of the given two integers, HCF of the given two integers. So we can write, this is the last divisor. So HCF of, therefore HCF of 60 and 100 is 20. Okay, now for these two integers, what is the HCF? 20 is the HCF of the given two integers. Okay, like this you can use the Euclid division lemma and you can find the HCF of any given two positive integers. Okay, this technique we can use for large numbers. Mostly we can use large numbers. Okay, next question. Suppose I told you for you, is given, show that given number is irrational. Okay, or find the log values, something they will give and they will ask. So that also I will explain for you. Suppose, show that root 5 plus root 3 is irrational. Number. Okay. So first we should consider this given number. Solution how we can do. Okay. Let first given that you have to write. Given that root 5 plus root 3. Now let we should consider, we should assume let root 5 plus root 3 is equals to a by b is a rational number. Is a rational. Rational means rational number, p by q form. A by b means p by q only form only, no. So you can take. Now for this 2 you can do square on both sides. Square on both sides. Okay. Now root 5 plus root 3 whole square. Here a by b whole square. Now it is in the form of a plus b whole square. Okay, a plus b whole square. What is the formula? A square plus b square plus 2ab is the formula. Where you can take the values also. Where a is equals here what? Root 5. B is equals to root 3. Okay, now you can expand in this form. Okay, root a square means root 5 square plus b square means root 3 square plus 2ab means root 5 root 3. Okay, is equals to a by b means a square by b square. Okay, now here you can take the values. 5 square, square root will cancel. Okay, so as these numbers you can write root 5 root 3 a square by b square. Okay, now 8 plus 2 root 5 root 3 is equal to a square by b square. Okay, now root 3 is equals to, now root 3 is equals to, root 3 is equals to a square by b square. Here transpose of plus 8 minus 8. Okay, here 2 root 5 is there still. Otherwise you have to take here it will multiply. Then in transpose of multiplication, division. So you can write divided by 2 root 5. Okay, here space not sufficient. So it is root 3. Root 3 value a square by b square minus 8 divided by 2 root 5. Okay, this is the irrational form. Okay, now what we have taken assumption is rational, but we got it here irrational number. So it is a contradiction. It is a contradiction. Okay, so this given number root 5 plus root 3 is irrational number. Irrational number. Okay, like this, any form they will ask. Here root 2 minus root 3 show that it is irrational, and suppose root 5 minus 3 show that it is irrational. Like this model questions they will ask in the examination. Okay, you should remember everyone. Okay, these are some models only I told for you. Bye-bye, because it is so less time. So further I will explain so many sums from the exercises also. Okay, thank you.